I'm Jake Trumbly. I'm here to present the Everyman's Weather Station. We started out as an idea to kind of create a cheaper weather station than those that are on the market right now, hopefully more accurate too. So using the power of the Arduino combined with two sensors, the DHT11 and the BMP180, we can get accurate temperature readings, barometric pressure readings, altitude, humidity, and we're working on wind speed, but I'll talk about that in a minute. So this is kind of what the product looks like. It's small enough that we can put it inside a casing. The casing itself won't cost much. We can 3D print one. We can find a way to get it waterproof. That's perhaps the hardest part. So my infants project kind of came from a childhood experience. It's something I've always wanted to do, but never had the skills to do. We had a bunch of small weather stations at home, the ones from our stick outside, and then ones back on the LCD screen. Those are great, but they seem to break after we get some water in them, which is beyond stupid. So we were trying to fix that problem. So we started with the Arduino itself, seeing how powerful that was. Went to the DHT11, that was simple. That was temperature and humidity. Humidity is great. Calculate heat index with that, we've done that, real field temperature. We can get it in Celsius, convert to Fahrenheit, and it'd be used all over the world, same with the heat index. And the BMP sensor was more of our advanced sensor. That's the altitude, barometric pressure. And you can use those numbers to get anything from predictions of rainfall, which NOAA uses a lot. If barometric pressure is dropping and substantial rain, you should expect rain in the next few hours. If it's pretty steady, then you know it's kind of cloudy like it is today. If it is rising, however, we're going to have hot, dry temperatures, usually. Wind direction plays a factor into that, but for the most part, you can just predict rainfall with pressure sensors. So, the next iteration of our project is going to include this anemometer. Sadly, the Arduino Uno, I could not figure out a way to make it powerful enough to calculate wind speed. Wind direction, we had some great ideas for using a potentiometer to see, we have this much electricity flowing through the variable resistor, then we can measure that, calibrate it to see which direction it's going. The problem with that is, it doesn't go full 360 degrees, it stops. So if you had wind spinning, you could get it caught. A motor might work for that. Sadly, we did not have the resources or the time for this presentation to explore that. We looked into it. It wasn't as easy as we had hoped. So we decided to focus more on the central project and doing this as another thing. The anemometer was totally 3D printed. We got the things to come along. Same idea as the wind direction. We can plug a motor into this. Calculate the period, use the period to calculate speed, like a physics mechanics problem. Certainly, we all know very well. But with the problem with this is the motor parts, they're hard to come by. You can use a bike speedometer, but you're not going to get very accurate reading. Personally, I would rather have the accurate reading and the longer work time than a cheap workaround. So we decided not to include this on the final project, but it is in the works and we are still working on this. Now the 4x20 LCD screen is great on many ways, but for our project, which we would put on top of a building or out a window, the LCD screen isn't as functional as I'd like it. So using a system of relays, which I have here, we could potentially route that back to a classroom, bounce it across campus using the Wi-Fi, which would be great for an environmental science class or a fellow who decides to use meteorology course. Accurate weather data down almost, I have it measuring every 5 minutes, we're going to measure every 10, every minute. If we have a storm coming in, it'd be really neat to see the graphs and the temperature falling and the pressure decreasing. That would be great for our science department. Environmental science is a class that talks a lot about weather. And accurate weather reading is almost to the degree of where you're sitting would be helpful. And the LCD screen could provide that level of, okay, here's a reading, this is what we're seeing right now. Graphic points, we could use it as a problem, we could use it as just a learning tool. Okay. Now the final iteration of the project has to do with what you see on the screen here. The openweathermap.org is where I got the original idea for the project. They essentially take a bunch of amateur weather stations, use the data coming in, and upload that to their website. So the way a normal weather station works, or weather.com or NOAA, they'll have a couple weather stations here and there, and they calculate the middle. They'll just take the average of the temperatures, or they'll calculate the wind speeds, see which way it's moving, and use an algorithm that way. That's great, but it can be inaccurate, especially if we're trying to do what we're doing, teaching a class, or in a sense, trying to predict the weather for sporting events. So Open Weather Map kind of fixes that problem. It lets you take your weather station you have with you and broadcast your data up to them, upload it. And they will make this very nice spreadsheet combined with NOAA's data and weather.com's. And you end up with accurate to the zip code data or to the address, depending on how many weather stations are there. And then they'll combine that with the more professional weather data to give you 5-day forecast, hourly forecast. But this is pretty much what we're seeing here. The temperature versus precipitation graph is great. It's excellent for teaching weather. A lot of my project was research-based, so I did a lot of work with NOAA's website, seeing how all this stuff comes together, the pressure, the humidity, the dew point. I really enjoyed that. So I can see how a weather station that may not look like much wiring-wise, the coding is really where we see the functionality of this, where we can see, okay, we're gonna have rain in the next 2 hours. And it's one thing to teach from a textbook, say if the barometer pressure is dropping, okay, we're gonna have rain in a few hours, but to actually see it dropping, to see it go from 29 millibars to 26, and be able to stand at the windows in the classroom at 70-minute block and actually see the force of the storm. That's where we're really gonna see this come to fruition, really see this point being made.